children, would you like to hear a magical Christmas story? This is a Christmas poem from my good friend John G. and his silly little blog. It's a lovely story about the true meaning of Christmas. So sit back and relax, close your eyes, and I'll take you to a magical place called Cincinnati, Ohio. The sun shone bright upon the street of this quaint neighborhood. Here friends and family soon would meet to feast and exchange goods. For Christmas time was on its way, and soon there would be snow. For every year it was this way in Southwest Ohio. The gardens would be free of strays, at least until the spring, when they return on warmer days to crap on everything. Inside this home, it's Christmas time for John G. and his bride. But Christmas is just not the same. John G. is sad inside. Why then, you ask, is John G. sad and even slightly pissed? He did not get the only thing upon his Christmas list. He sent a note to Santa Claus and listed just one thing. He wrote, "Dear Santa, all I want this year is to join Queen." The elves all scoffed at this request, but what they didn't know was when Queen played at Wembley, Santa sat in the front row. Saint Nick had been a huge Queen fan, and few folks would believe that he has a tattoo of the band beneath his right coat sleeve. "Let's make this gift a special one for everyone to see." And so he made a special plan, only for John G. His gift, it seemed, had come at last, and Santa had come through. John G. had made it past round one, and soon would come round two. The news reporters called to talk, then John G.'s alma mater. The folks who knew him spread the word to mothers, brothers, daughters. So John G.'s phone rang off the hook. His Facebook wall was full. And for the first time in his life, John G., the dork, felt cool. Kind words from friends and family, and folks he didn't know, said, "Best of luck, you are the man, and John G., way to go." The votes poured in from everywhere as John G. passed the time by choosing outfits for round three with any clothes that he could find. For many days, the votes came in, and compliments as well. Not only did folks like his song, they said John G. was swell. His smile was large as he awoke. At last, his big day came. He opened up the final list. But wait, where was his name? He sat and stared in disbelief upon the final list, still hoping yet to see his name somewhere he might have missed. The more he looked, the more he knew. No John G. on this screen. He sadly closed his laptop down. John G. would not be in Queen. His sad failure would be made worse, for he would have to tell the story of his sad defeat to those who wished him well. Folks still would call and text and post to find out how he did. No longer would he get to be John G., that really cool kid. He went to see Santa Claus. He had a bone to pick, and if John G. would get a chance, he'd punch out old Saint Nick. Still filled with sadness and mixed with rage, John G. went to the square. A poster hanging by his house said Santa would be there. John G. yelled, "Santa, let's have words." And before Santa spoke, John G. jumped onto Santa's back for a rear naked choke. And as they fell onto the ground, there was a sudden crack. Then Santa yelled in agony,
"Oh God, you broke my back."
As John G. stood up from the ground, he looked straight at Saint Nick and said, "That was just the payback from your dirty little trick." "You see, John G., you have it wrong. Your mindset needs a shift. You've missed my whole entire point of giving you that gift. You know how much you love to sing, and music is your life. I also know how much you love your family and your wife." You also really love your friends, and your co-workers too. I thought the perfect gift would be to show how they love you. To show you how much people care, I picked the rock band Queen, so you could see how many folks would help you chase your dream. The dreams you had to tour the world, hotels, limos, and bling. Without the people that you love, these wouldn't mean a thing. As Junji walked back in his house, he found the best surprise. All his friends and family were waiting there inside. No time or place he'd rather be than Christmas time in Cincinnati. Goodbye, children, and have a Merry Christmas.